Good morning. Before doing the Twin Heart Meditation, we require to do certain exercises so that our body opens out and the energy channel can easily flow in and we do not have any blockages. So the first exercise which we are going to do is the eye rotation. All of us know that our eyes get very easily affected when we do any type of work. So the eye rotation is, you rotate clockwise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then you reverse it to the left so that you energized it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, 11, and 12. This eye rotation when we do, especially for people who are in the computer world, who are always looking to the monitor, it really helps them. In fact, every one of us can do it every day. It doesn't take much time. So this stops us from, it actually activates the muscles and it helps us to see better and our vision does not get affected when we grow old. The next rotation, next exercise which you talk about is the neck exercise, wherein you turn the neck one sideways, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Up, down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. By doing this neck rotation, what happens is that all the muscles which are very tight, caught up here, will just loosen up and you feel much more freer. Because when we are doing the meditation, the channel of the energy should flow in easily and it should not get stuck here. The next exercise which we do is the upper body twist. Do 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8, 8, 9, 9, 10, 10, 11, 11, 12, and 12. The next exercise which we talk about is the hip rotation. We rotate our hips so that the hip, most of us have the problem, the waist. The waist pain comes because of this, because we don't even have the time to rotate it. 1, rotate clockwise, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, we should smile when you're doing this. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Then reverse it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. The next exercise is the shoulder exercises, which most of us have the pain, have a very lot of pain in the shoulder. So what we do is that we can either rotate it, if you have space, we rotate it very high, or we can fold our hands and rotate like this. So either way, okay, let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, then we do with the flick of hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Then the wrist has to be rotated. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Then the fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So when you do the fingers, afterwards what we have is the spine exercise. Most of us have a pain at the back when we are working a lot. When I'm sitting and working especially. So the spine exercise, if you do the spine exercise, your back becomes okay, you don't have any pain. You breathe in while coming up and then and breathe out while going down like this. When you do this exercise, what happens is the spine gets contracted and expanded. So when you do this, it really exercises the spine. Like this, we do about 12 times. After this, what we do is that the football kick, nowadays we are all in football world, is better do the kicks, okay? What we do is that we do the exercise for the knees. What we do is that we just move it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. This is to ensure that the knees, at the knees, the energy when it passes through does not get locked up. Then the other leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Then one more exercise which we do is the, which is called semi-squats. That is nothing but you do this. You have seen the children normally do this when they like to dance. Actually, when they do this about 100 times, they say that we get a lot of money. Yeah. So all of you start doing this exercise every day. Even if you want more money, just do this. And if you want a good job, just do this. So this exercise will help you to get a lot of things. So do this for about 50 times or 100 times daily. You will find that you have a lot of money. No jokes, things will come your way. Even if you're looking for a job, the job will also come to you. So this exercise is very important. It actually, when you do this exercise, your entire spine and at the back, everything becomes stronger. So you're able to stand better. Okay, this is about 50 times you do. So this exercise, then we have the, what you have, the ankle exercise. All of us do the ankle exercise, right? So the ankle exercise is very important because when you're walking, most of the times your legs are tight. You're not able to do. So the ankle exercise, you do it again, 12 counts. Rotate clockwise 12 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Then anti-clockwise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Up, down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. The other leg. If you do these exercises, what happens is that the blood circulation flows easily and you do not end up in anything like stroke or any aspect of it. Even people who are suffering from normal pain and arthritis, everything will go off if you do these exercises every day, maybe once a day or twice a day is good. And then do up, down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, this finishes the exercises. You know that we clap our hands, right? Most of the times we clap our hands. When we clap our hands, we clap it fully so that it energizes, it removes all the negative things which is around. So clap it like this. So today, this morning, I was seeing in one of the Indian TVs that by clapping the hands, they say that even the body gets energized and becomes better and all the negative things are completely removed. So these are the simple exercises. You may ask me why I'm wearing a tie and a shirt and doing. I said this is for the executives also. Anyone can do this before going. It just takes 5 minutes. If you do these exercises whenever you're feeling tired or whenever you're feeling that your body is very exhausted, you just do this. You can recoup the energy because the energy is always there. You're always connected with the upper being. So you can have the flow of the energy very easily and you become better. We can do the healing using our hands also by moving our hand. But if you want to do it faster, we use something called crystal. This is called a laser crystal. And this is called a receiver, a ball, a small pink ball. It's also a crystal. It's a pink crystal, quartz crystal. So this crystal is like a laser beam. When you use the crystal, it just goes in, penetrates into the energy body and removes the dirty energies from there and like a laser beam, and then throws it. You know that these days, all technology is all with laser. We have laser-based operations of the eye, of the body, any part. Nowadays, we use laser beam. Similarly, this crystal is also functions like the laser beam. It just enters into the energy body and removes the dirty energies and throws it. You know, when you use this crystal, it can remove the dirty energies very fast. The pain can be removed very fast. Yes, you can use your hand also, But when you're using your crystal, it is very, very fast. It can remove very fast. You saw how we can do it with the hand, but if there are something which is very painful and has to be done faster, this way you can heal the patient just by taking it out. What I'm doing is that I'm scanning to find out what is the, how much is there, and then removing it. Do you not feel better now? What's happening? You feel better?
40%.
Yeah, 40% gone. Okay, that's good. In just 2 minutes, 40% gone is a very good sign. However, in case something remains, we wash this crystal with alcohol or salt water. This ball is nothing but an activator. It is meant to absorb the energies from the atmosphere and transfer it into pink. You know, this is baby pink sort of a thing, because this pink crystal, this crystal absorbs the energy and makes it into loving kindness. The pink is supposed to be loving kindness. When you do with this, when you absorb this energy, it becomes a source of absorbing the energy and directs it into pink color, and the patient gets healed much, much faster. However, without using that also we can do it, with if you have a proper heart to do something to help people. But if you don't have a heart and say, hey, this person has come, and then you do it, it'll not work out. So you have to have a kind heart, a loving heart, and have a concern for the person. Not that the patient has come and you think about him, oh, what, he's got a pain. But if you make your faces, if you make faces, then the pain will not go. Now, how are you feeling now? 80% gone. That's a good sign. As I'm talking to you, the pain is gone. So nothing psychic. Distant healing is okay now. The distant healing is also possible. So don't ask me for distant healing, okay? You can come, but then you should come and register yourself to learn it, so that you can help yourself and others. Don't ask me, last time when I said distant healing, the moment I said distant healing, all the calls came. I have this problem, that problem, please heal me. How many people can I heal? Yes, I can heal in there if there is an emergency. But then, please come and register and help yourself.
I'm Ivy Tanner. I'm also a pranic healer. When I was coming here, I was very skeptical. I didn't know what was being done here. But I had the courage, I came and learnt. I can now heal a whole lot of sicknesses. Even this morning, I had a case of cancer. And before the woman left here, she was very happy. If I can learn and I can heal, why can't you? This thing, there's nothing superstitious about it. There's nothing juju about it. It's very scientific. We use energies from the sun, the air, and the ground. So I encourage everybody, if somebody like me can also heal today, even in the class when I was having the lectures, I used it to heal my own daddy. And he was very happy. So why can't you also come and learn? I encourage all of us to come and learn for the betterment of our nation, Ghana. If we are very healthy, the nation is also healthy, and there will be a lot of productivity.
Anyone can learn pranic healing, but they should be above 16 years, not less than 16 years, until unless you are some divine child, but not less than 16 years. But the age limit is restricted. Only below 16 years, they cannot do it. Others can do it.
Whatever land you land on, the earth is just a dead thing you can claim. But I know every rock and tree and creature has a life, has a spirit, has a name. You think the only people who are people are the people who look and think like you. But if you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you learn the things you never knew, you never knew. colors of the wind. Can you paint with all the colors of the wind?
She's got a chest pain and a waist pain. We'll first scan her to find out how much is the chest pain. So what we do is that we use our hand. With the bare hands, we can find out the scanning. This is called scanning. The first procedure is that we interview the patient to find out what is your problem. So what's your problem, you said?
Chest and waist pain.
Waist pain, okay. So now the chest pain means how much of chest pain is there. What we do is that we move our hand down like this. We can move the hand like this to find out where exactly the problem is. To find out where the chest pain is. The chest pain is what we are looking for, and there's something there. What we do is that we first check what is the aura is, how big the aura is, from scanning to find out what is the aura precision. So this is where the aura is, whereas around the chest area, the energy is too much. Maybe there is a lot of congestion. Maybe around the solar plexus, which we call it the energy center there also too much of energy is there. Because there is too much of energy, there's a congestion there. So what we do is that in pranic healing is that we move out all the dirty energies. The first procedure is, please come sit down. So we finish with the scanning process. The next process is that, keep your hand like this. Sit straight. Connect your tongue to the palate. Okay? Connect your tongue to the upper palate. Connect your tongue to the upper palate. Close your mouth, close your eyes, and say a small prayer to God in your mind. Don't have to open your mouth. You just say a small prayer to God, thanking you for healing you completely of all your problems. Because God is only healing. I'm only an instrument. We are only an instrument to heal. Anyone can learn this healing system, so no problems at all. So what we do is that now we do a general sweeping, first for you. So the general sweeping is that you come here, one, we're doing the general sweeping. We first start out from the head area to down. We do the general sweeping like this. And then come down from the head to the toe. Come down from the head to the toe. Take it and throw it in the salt water. See, as we are doing is that we are completely bringing it down from the head area down to the soul. And removing it from all the aura. The complete aura is cleaned first. It's like actually when you have something like raking, when you have a garden dirty, what do? You have a raker to clean it off. So you just clean it like this and take it out. That's what we're doing. The dirty energies are there in the body. So what we do is that we do this general sweeping for the entire body first. Since she's got a waist pain and other things, what we do is that we do it at the back area also, complete. This is what is called the sweeping. Now, since her chest area is painful, so what we do is that we move our hand like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Collect and then throw it. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Collect, throw. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Collect, throw. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Collect, throw. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Collect, throw. 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Collect, throw. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. Collect, throw. So when you finished about 30 or 35 times, what happens is that the energy, actually 30 times is sufficient. So you find that now the release can to find out what the energy is. It's much better now. And then afterwards, you remove it again and then energize her. So what we do for energizing is that the next procedure after cleaning is that we energize. What we do is that anyone can get this thing energizing done. You can raise your hand, the left hand and the right hand. You can absorb the energies. The moment you feel the energy is coming into your hand, with the other hand, you direct it to the place where you are energizing. So I am directing this energy to the near her stomach where there's a problem there, solar plexus, and also to the back of the heart, visualizing the back heart. So you feel that she's feeling better. Once she feels better, what we do is that once there's a pushback or something like that, we stabilize it and cut it off. That's what we do, is what is called energizing. After we finish the energizing, we again reintroduce the patient to ask, how are you feeling now?
What was wrong with you before you came? Actually, I was feeling heart and then waist pain before I came here. As for the heart, 4 years now. The waist, just a year now.
So how do you feel now?
Oh, I'm feeling better now. Fine, I'm feeling very fine.
The baby is not well, and she's having a problem of dysentery and not being very, very healthy. And she has been having a problem. So what we are doing now is called general sweeping. First we do the general sweeping for the child. It's better to sweep as much as possible for the child so that she gets healed faster. So what we are doing is that we do a general sweeping. You have seen that in the animations also that we do the general sweeping like this. Okay. So by sweeping off the dirty energies and putting it into the salt water bucket, what happens is that the negative elementals, negativities which are there in the child goes into the bucket. And we take it out from the child and then we put it down. Okay. All the disease energies from the child will be removed like this. And because she's having a problem with the stomach, what we do is that we move her hand near the stomach, visualizing there's a stomach is there, and we do the healing for her stomach now. So that she gets healed completely. For a child, it's very simple. Anyone can do it. You can move your hand along the stomach area if the child is suffering from dysentery or any problem. So we just move the hand like this and remove the disease energy from the stomach of the child so that the energy, the negative energies will be completely removed. In fact, for a child, if we just move a hand like this in front of the child, maybe about 10 or 15 times, most of the problems are solved. But you should have a bucket of water where you throw it, and later on you wash your hands or you clean your hands and put it in the salt water. This is nothing but a rubbing alcohol which has been poured with water, diluted with water, so that it can get healed. So by doing just this, the child gets healed faster. Anyone can do it, even you can try it at home, but then you should have a salt water. But for learning properly, what you do is that you come to us for learning it. And it's very simple. Within 2 days, we teach you how to do the basic course. And by just moving your hand, you can remove the dirty energies from the body. Just by moving your hand. You see, the child is much better than what she was before. She's at least now active. And you can heal yourself and others.
I was feeling pains on my shoulder. My waist. It was about 3 years ago. It is a big miracle because it has gone. I don't feel anything on my shoulder again. Very big. My waist too. It has gone. Yeah, I don't feel any pain.
I had a problem with my eyes, my neck, and all part of my body. Especially when I had a cough. When the place is a bit dark, I cannot see. Then now, I see it's better than before. Yeah, than before.
It's better.
Yeah.
Can you see numbers on your phone now?
Yes, yeah. I can clearly see it.
Yes. Since when have you been practicing pranic healing?
Since 2003.
Yes. How did you hear of it?
I was along Ring Road Central and I got to Pyramid House. There I saw a sign, healing. I've been interested in healing for a long time. So when I saw that healing, I just wanted curiosity to see exactly what it is. So I went there. The gentleman who was doing the healing asked me why I was holding the stick. I said, because of my waist and my legs. And I asked him if I could be healed if I joined them. He said yes. So automatically I enrolled, got enrolled, and then I started the course the next day. And he told me all about it, and I joined immediately. That weekend, I was at school with them, and I got to know a lot about it. But in the course of it, I realized that not what I brought, that is my waist and legs, not alone. I saw that there were other ailments about me which I didn't mention. but automatically it went off gradually. And I took the course, and when I finished the course, I was invited to join them to go to other places to heal. And I continued with it, and I really enjoyed it, enjoyed the healing tremendously. So I got attached to them, and I'm now, they call me a healer.
Can you tell us a bit more about the healing, how you perform the healing?
Yes. Now, I got to understand the process of it. We use energy to heal a person. Formerly, I didn't know.
Would you advise anybody to go into pranic healing?
Yes, madam. I will vehemently advise them. Everybody must be interested, because I saw in the book the discoverer of this pranic healing. He said that, or he believed that, it is useful for every house, every family, to have at least one pranic healer among them. And I discovered that it's true. It is really very beneficial, and that we should all, if possible, join them and then be able to heal ourselves and others.
Can you tell us a bit more about the energy of the sun that you feel in your hands?
Usually such questions, when they come, I try to refer them to television. You see, when you see on top of so many houses, they have got the dish. And the dish receives the energy and transfers it to the TV box or whatever it is. Do you see the energy that goes into the dish to be transferred? That's just it. The energy that we also apply is as the one you see or you feel in the box. It comes automatically from above. A big tree has got ground, even all these things, they have energy down there. That's why when we are trying to heal, we remove our shoes, or trying to heal any patient, we remove our shoes so that the thing can, the generating energy from the ground will be capable of penetrating to the body of the patient.
Do the healing using our hands also, by moving our hand, but if you want to do it faster, we use something called crystal. This is called a laser crystal. And this is called a receiver, a ball, a small pink ball. It's also a crystal. It's a pink crystal, quartz crystal. So this crystal is like a laser beam. When you use the crystal, it just goes in, penetrates into the energy body and removes the dirty energies from there, and like a laser beam, and then throws it. Mm-hmm.